see you in the house. Straight from Philly, straight from PA, y'all already know. Y'all gonna see it. Y'all gonna be like, oh snap, that's Mark. Y'all know what it is.
Baba every time fire. How you doing,
sister? What's going on? How you ain't over here?
Hold on, I got you ready, George.
How you doing? Peace, brothers. Where y'all from?
Atlanta. I'm from Chicago.
All right.
Yeah.
You coming to see them? You gonna be at the conference tomorrow?
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
All right. All right.
You gotta put that work in.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Peace, brother. Peace. Where you from, brother?
I'm from uptown in the Bronx.
Oh, I know you're gonna be at the conference tomorrow, right?
Of course I am. Me and my brother, he couldn't make it today. I took off these 2 days for work. I've been looking forward for this event probably for about a month or two since y'all posted it up there, so very excited, and I'm here.
Yes, sir. This is my first time to the museum, so I can't wait.
This is your first time?
Yes, sir.
I was just telling the brother, I probably was here when I was a kid in school, and it didn't really mean nothing. I mean, as far as I can't even remember the point that I just came here. So now I feel special that I'm actually going to get something, and I feel blessed that I'm in the presence of so much greatness.
Thank you,
peace,
brother.
Peace.
Peace, brother. How are you? Where you from?
From Richmond, VA.
Richmond, VA?
For sure.
Yeah, I know you're going to be at the conference tomorrow, right?
No doubt.
Yes,
no
sir. You're going in the museum, I'm sure,
for
right?
Sure, man.
Dr.
Sure.
Reggie, the master teacher.
No doubt.
Makes all the difference in the world when you got people that know what they're looking at.
Absolutely.
And the understanding of how to teach it.
For
yes,
sure.
Sir.
For sure.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you.
Peace. Mighty Dredd.
Peace.
Where you from,
Dredd? Richmond, Virginia, man.
Richmond. All
yeah,
right.
Man.
I know you're going to be at the conference tomorrow, right?
True indeed. True indeed,
yes,
man.
Yes, sir.
Came all this way for it.
Beautiful.
Yeah,
nice
man.
To meet you, brother.
You too, brother.
Peace. Peace. How you
peace.
Doing, brother Jamel? Where
I'm
you
good,
from?
I'm good. I'm good, man. You know what I'm saying?
Where you
couldn't
from, brother?
I came here from South Florida.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I just got it.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying? Just came fresh off the plane, LaGuardia Airport, like about an hour ago.
That's what it is.
You know what I mean?
Thank you, brother. Peace and Black Power.
What's up there,
how you doing, brother?
How you
where
doing?
You from?
Columbus, Georgia, sir.
Oh, man, you came all the way up here. I know you're going to be at the conference tomorrow, right?
Most definitely, sir. Supporting the Amaral squad. That's the family right there,
that's
sir.
What I'm
yeah.
talking about. That's
Mad
what
Jive,
it is.
All them.
Thank you for giving me a minute, brother.
Yes, sir. Black yes, African sir. Power.
Black what African on, Power. Brother? Hey, brother, how you?
How you?
You from Georgia as well?
Yeah, we up from Georgia. I'm from Harlem. But I live in Georgia now,
okay.
yeah. So
all
you
right,
come
brother.
Up, check Reggie out, get this info.
Yes, sir.
I mean, take it back
teacher.
Down south, baby.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Thank you for giving me a minute.
Thank you, bro.
All right, bro.
They control the treasure of our birthright.
created what we call the so-called Big Bang. And that created atoms, solar systems, ultimately something that's more important to us that was created, things like minerals and elements, right? And things, right, no flash. And
that created or discovered? I don't know what you said created.
We're talking about as solar systems are creating and explosions coming, elements are being created. Okay. Elements are created. We're talking about the first time.
Okay.
September, the first time of everything. Mm-hmm. Instead of God said, let there be light, and God is doing everything. Well, nature is doing this. Mm-hmm. The quantum world is doing this. This is before any of that. Before God spoke, before a man could even conceive of a God, mm-hmm. these things were there. Mm-hmm. And we're talking about waves. We're talking about quantum. So those things create what we call the spark of life in the cosmic form, and then ultimately you get the chemistry, and then you get to jump from chemistry to biology, and that's where we come into. But this is billions and billions of years after that first spark. So you can look at the Bible for a story, but it's not scientific. We are now Valley scientists, and the thing about it is, what I'm showing you is science, right? Now, your religion, that's fine. You can keep it in, and you can use it to contrast if you still have it. I'm not trying to take away your God. I'm trying to make you gods, right? So that's a big difference, right? So here, this is alabaster. It's important because light shines through alabaster. Mm-hmm. And guess who the alabaster was for? For women. It is what the king, the noble people, this is what you bring home to your wife. Mm-hmm. Kemet is a celebration of women.
Not Louis Vuitton, no.
It's not a barbaric society. It's not a European society. It's not a Sumerian society. It's none of those societies. It's our society, and at the center of what we do is women. Right? First dynasty, we passed the pyramid doors, right? And I'll give out a little piece. We're into the third and fourth dynasty, because the museum can't do second and third dynasties. They can't put pyramids in here. You got to go to Kemet. So maybe we'll take a trip to Kemet. But before that, we want you to understand what's going on. But when we see something like this, this is from one of the pyramid builders. What do we have here? We have Sa Ray. You see the sun is Ray, and the bird is Sa, like Sa Meta, right? And then we have the KF. We have the F, the viper, and we have the ray. So we have cat prey. So this is the pyramid. There's Khufu, Khafre, and Menkaure, which are the three pyramid builders. This is cat prey. A Nile Valley African can look up there and say, this is my language. I can see someone. All right? So, no. That is a chenille, right? It became what you call a cartridge. When the French, when the French came, but it signifies an important name. Now, I'm handing out some pictures. Some of the pictures had to do with the early kings and their wives, because we have names for their wives. And the other one is a lineage chart, right? Okay. They are all going to use this phrase, this prayer, and this prayer says, offerings to the king, right? And then it talks about the offerings that the deceased will have, and it's called the Hotep Dinarsut. The Hotep Dinarsut is the offering, and we're going to see it several times, right? And I passed out something that you can read about the prayer, and we'll talk about it. So if you continue to follow us on the conference, follow our websites, and if I get your emails, I'll email you the stuff, so you're not missing anything. But this prayer right here is one of the oldest prayers, right?
Let's put this out. You said form, right?
Yeah, but this is not cool. This is not Khufu. I have to read the label to see who this is unless I see his name, right?
Right.
Okay. Well, you can be a noble person, it doesn't have to be a king. Okay. Now this is very important. Look at this piece right here. make room for other people? Can y'all move?
Step closer to the side. Closer to the camera.
Now, something, I'm going to repeat myself, so if you don't hear, let the people pass and go. Look at this piece right here. Look at this piece right here. Notice something. It has two coatings. It has two coatings. It has an outer coating with the words. And it has an inner coating. The Africans built with cement. We're talking about science. This is how the pyramids were built. This is a science. Do you understand? We had a concrete that we used. So when they talk about us going and chopping the blocks, no, we was making a cement. The second thing that's more important is that, no, there's some Africans that say we were levitating things. No, we were manufacturing and building. We weren't levitating. We don't do spooky African stuff. Right. We don't do spooky people who are trying to use their brightness to trick you into believing that they got a signal that you don't have. This is cement, family. And this is something that your ancestors gave to the world. Any problem?
No. Okay.
The Africans went to war.
Constantly.
Okay. Let me just repeat that for the rest of the people, right? Did everybody hear me about the cement? Now, did the Africans go to war? Yes. Africa was invaded. Kemet was invaded over and over and over again. This is the picture of the Tinahu or the Libyans, right? Okay. Now, I have a few sheets. The Tom is pronounced different ways. But I have all the enemies of ancient Egypt on that sheet right there, right? You can pass it around. Is this a Hebrew? No.
Definitely not.
It has nothing to do with their culture. But when people see this, they say, yes, they had slaves. No, we had prisoners. We had prisoners. Why? We have to maintain our society. We can't let everybody cross our borders. That's the problem with our community. Everybody can come in, right? The Koreans can come in, the Asians can come in, the Russians can come in and feed off of us and give us nothing back. We have control of our society. This is a symbol of control. If you're not ready to do this, you're not with us.
Right. A quick question. So they would make a statue of a prisoner in what, a submissive position? Would this be in a public court?
Of course. It would be in a temple. Everybody would see it. This is who our enemies are. They would take the little children and young people, like this little brother right here. Step up here. They would take this brother and they say, you see this brother? Look at him. He's not you.
Right.
Don't worry about the complexion. Look at his hair. Right? This is not you. You're going to have to protect your mother and your father. And if you don't do that, you're not my son. I'm going to make another son. Are you prepared to do that? Are you prepared to take protect the family?
Like, I mean, I'm ready.
You're ready. That's a big responsibility.
If you wanted a church, if you wanted a synagogue, if you wanted any religious place, this place right here is your religious place because it has all your stuff in it, right? So you're going to have to respect it, right? This is your religion right here. The history of your people is your religion. Right. Kemet, the center of Kemet is black man, woman, and child. This is what we are. Black man, woman, and child. You understand? This is different than what you see as the pharaohs. We're not concerned about the pharaohs. We're concerned about the people that make it possible for the Nosut to rule. Right? Or the Sarah to rule. And these are these people. These humble people with his staff of wisdom, right? And his sword to protect this woman. That's who we are.
Are they symbolic of Nubians?
Not necessarily, because Africa was... Egypt was a cosmopolitan African society of different African people, not just Nubians.
And last point on that, the features are kind of interesting, especially on the female. So that's not a custom. Well, even though I know we
there are different type of black females in Kemet. You see, look at the sisters over here. They're different type of sisters, right? So you can't look at a phenotype and just decide on a phenotype. You have to know what their heart is and what their values and what she says. Okay? Okay, this is a funerary wall. I gave out the prayer of the Hotep Dinarsut to a number of people. If you, I don't know which one you have in your hand. You have the enemies. Anyone has the ones with the offerings? No, that's the enemies. Okay. Thank you, though. Okay. So on here, I'm going to show it to you much, much more clearer. But this is the funerary wall. You see the hidden door? The hidden door is to the ancestral realm. Right? Now, we do different things with our mind. When we lose a loved one, we like to think that they went to the afterworld. But guess what? None of us know because none of us been there.
Well, been back to talk about it.
So we can conceptualize it. Right. This is simply that conceptualization. Mm-hmm. On top of it, you see the man standing there with those two kind of U's and the owl on top of this thing. Mm-hmm. Right? That's his name. That's his name is Mechie. Mechie is his name. I know his name. I know who he is because he's sitting there, right? So I'm having a conversation with him. And he's saying, this is my offering to the king, to Inpo, right? And my name is Mechie. And then on here, I can't show you all of his titles, but he has titles to represent who he is. And then on the top of the person's name, you will see his name on the top. So a Metamenta scholar would read it as Ka'em Sinu. Ka'em Sinu. But if you want to get a grasp of how the ancient people of your ancestors thought, you can look behind the hidden wall and you can see what his what they conceived of is as his spirit, right? Because over here they would give offerings. His family would come like a regular tombstone and give offerings, right? All of this is our conception of paying honor to our families, right? And all the good things, because we are all important. You know the difference between Nile Valley Africans and other groups of people? Is that guess what? You have no record of the ancient Hebrews. You don't know their names. You don't have the record of the ancient Christians. They lived and died. You don't know their names. You don't know. You only know Abraham. You only know their patriarchs. Here, people are important. You are important. You're not dust, right? Your ancestors said that everybody's name, which is a ren, is important. Everybody's name is a spell. A ren. A ren is a spell. A name. Okay. I went to the first dynasty. I skipped to the fourth dynasty. Now, Kemet was in its first intermediate period. The old kingdom had failed.
Great. Can all meet you, please? Have everyone step as closely as possible so we can keep the open walkway for them?
Kemet had failed for its own success. You know what they started doing? They started hiring their brothers and their sisters, right? Their uncles and their cousins. Right? They stopped hiring skilled people. They started going into what you call nobility. Right? But guess what? They wasn't fit to rule. So at some point, Kemet went into chaos. And out of that first intermediate period, right, a new kingdom begins to emerge. So now we're in a period where there's a big exhibit upstairs on the Middle Kingdom, but we're going into this period of the Middle Kingdom where Kemet was reformulating himself after an absence for a couple hundred years. Is that fine? Everybody understand that? Now, this table right here, okay, so let me just do the dynasties. I started with pre-dynastic. I showed you the first dynasty of Nosuch, Nirmer, and Djer, Djet, they were there, and their seals. And these seals was the first writing, if I didn't say it then, that was the first writing in the world. When we talk about grammar, right? Not just signs and symbols, but actually stuff that makes sense that you can repeat. This is a piece of bread. This is Hotep. Everybody come over here and look on this side. This symbol right here means Hotep. It's just a piece of bread on top of a pan, right? It means offering. This is where you put fruit, you put beer, you put meat, but this is not no blood sacrifice thing. This is not where they sacrifice humans. The other people will tell us, like the Hebrews and the other people, Africans sacrifice people. No. Right? This is an offering table for satisfaction as we give thanks. These are an important part of our team. And so he's on his way. Okay, so we look at these things, and remember, every Nasut has different names because he does different things. He has different titles, right? So when we do many, the religious people confuse us as many gods and many things. No, it's many aspects of ourselves. So the king, he has many. He has a Nephi name, right? And on the top of his Nephi name is Wehem Masut Neb, ear, right? And then he has a Nasut Bini name. You see the B and the T? The B and the Sedge and the T? That's his Nasut Bini name. So anytime you see the B, that's usually the king's name, and that's his mystery system name, the Nasut Bini name. And then over here you see his big Nasut Bini name, which is Hotep, Eshotep, Pet Ib, right? Inside there. And then he has a Sarah name, like Sarah Sun Seti. That's where Sarah the general gets his name. Sarah, son of Ray, but it's really aspect of Ray.
So the key to our success is our cities, states, nations, everywhere around the world. And we're in a very important part. It was a good question because we're here, we're going to look at someone's name, and his name is Senorset. Senorset is named, the Greeks are sorceress. So what happened with Kemet after the 12th dynasty? This is the son of Amenhotep. And you know what he does? He goes as far as Greek, trying to civilize people, because his idea was, well, we teach these barbarians civilization, maybe they will respect us and respect themselves. So he went as far as Greece. So the early Greeks talk about sorceress as someone giving them knowledge. This is the Nasut Bini Senorset that gave them the knowledge. Right? So let's look at his name. Ka. Say it again. Kepler Ray. And Miss is Ankh Nisut. Ankh, you know the Ankh sign? You see that M, right? That thing that looks like an M? Well, guess what? The ancient Kemetic M is our M. Do you understand that the alphabet that we use comes from ancient Kemet? The I, the Miss, the all grammar comes from ancient Egypt. What do they say? They say Phoenician, right? Well, who were the masters of Phoenicia? Ancient Kemet. So why do y'all go for it when they say, well, you know, it's phonetic, it's phonics, Phoenician, right? No, the Phoenicians, they don't tell you who the masters or the civilizers of them were, and these were on the Nile Valley Africans. So a lot of, do you know the uniliterals, the single sound, they go from A to Z? They go to A to Z. You come to my class, I'll teach you. All the sounds go from A to Z, so when you make simple sounds, like the T sound, like you see the duck is the we call it the uchik, and then the half circle is the T. So that's ut, right? So they have a U, they have a T, they have a V, they have an S. The Usher staff, and you see that candy cane?
Yes.
Or it looks like a candy cane? That's S. Their S is interesting because it's almost similar to our S. Mm-hmm. Right? You see the mouth is R.
Okay.
You have circles T. Mm-hmm. And that door bolt or the fist, do the right that oh. that
the
that
bump.
Door bolt, okay. Right? The fist bump is S, and then wavy lines is N. So his name is Usher, right? Sin. Usher Ret Sin. And the Europeans say, I don't like that. Maybe we do it's an honorific thing. So we're not gonna say Usher Ret Sin. We're gonna call him Senorset.
Let me ask you a question. How you know which way to start reading it?
Oh, when a symbol is facing you, you're talking to it. Oh, so you okay. Start where it's facing you. So we might say Ankh Nisut. And then I said Usher because the cane is facing me.
Okay.
He's looking at me, yeah. Right? And then when a living thing is, that's the way it goes. And then, so that's it. See over there with the chick is facing me. So I'm going to say Ankh Nisut.
Okay.
The direction is, if the words are looking at you, you're communicating. That's okay. Spirituality. Okay. If it's looking away from you, going the other side, it's like when you're talking to her and you're having a disagreement and she's walking away and you run over here. Right?
Yeah.
That's spirituality.
All right.
This is an aspect of someone's home, right? Here you have gold, right? These are the things. Yes, this is a queen. So she's got more than many. But they tell you who they are. They tell you the things that's around their house and their home. Example of a family. Now look, this is not a king and a queen. This is a regular family. The circular thing right here, this is a wand. This is a spell wand. This is when they, when they're trying to do hecka, when they are contemplating to see if they can communicate with the quantum world, right? That's the wand right there. Those are mirrors. Again, they tell you who they are as African people, so you can see the Africanness of these people, not the Europeanness of it. All right?
So that's where the witch wand came from, right?
The what? That's correct. The wand and all that. When Europeans saw this, they made up their minds as to what they thought it was going to be.
Excuse me,
right?
Brother Red.
Brother Red.
Yes, that's about, well, this thing right here is to hold your neck up, right? And there might be a bed. There's no bed over here, but there's pictures of beds. Yeah, that's a bed right there. That's the model of a bed, right? And that's the house right there. That's an example of a house.
Show that in,
you got a
single
staff
here? What's the Asian women that sleep like this to keep your neck elongated?
And we're going to go into the 18th dynasty, and we're going to go into another very special place. See, my tour is all about the women. Because the women is what we hold up as the high ideas. We do our work, but this particular place that we're going into right now is a very sacred place, one of the more sacred places in this museum. For us, right? This is a place where the rulership of the whole great empire of Kemet solidifies under a sister. Her name is who? Huh? See, this is when the young soldiers speak first, right? You gotta love that, right? Emen Hatshepsut takes hold of Kemet. Now, there were other queens that did this, but Hatshepsut is the more famous because Europeans make her more famous, and you're going to see why, but she takes hold of this great civilization of Kemet. So our civilizations were ruled by the most capable, and if the most capable was a woman, well, God damn it, we're going to let her rule. Do you understand what I'm saying? No man, now later, yes, she did have a problem with her younger brother, who felt that she had too much time, and he got a little upset, but he was also a great ruler. But guess what? She had her time for us. My tour is a little bit different than other people's tours because I get to show you something. Again, we're talking about science and technology. We're not talking about spookiness. We're not talking about levitating blocks and pyramids and nothing like that. We're talking about Africans building for African family, right? Here's the queen, Hatshepsut, or at least I think that that's who she is because I don't see any names so I can read the metadata. Because normally I would look for the metanetra. But notice something. There's a layer, which it seems to be a cement, right? And on top of it is another layer. So we were building with cement. Do you know how technically advanced that you have to be 2,000 to 3,000 years to build the cement that lasts this long, this stable? This is science right here. You see this right here? These are the new bowls. Like we have new, Nunet. Right? This is cosmic material in the concept of the ancient Egyptians. So she's showing you her science. She is showing that she knows how to wield the science of the universe. That's what this is. This is the new pose. But more importantly is that she, yes, she may have a beard and it fell off. She's ruling like a man. She's ruling like Horus. But Horus is not capable. So she will rule. And you can see the form is kind of feminine. So we went to a conference a couple of years ago. So we went to a conference, Kemet on trial. How many people went to Kemet on trial?
I saw.
The Hebrews who were in that conference, who historically, they lived in the Nile Valley for many years until they had in their book, an argument with an Igbo Norsut, according to them.
But they were fed, they grew from 39 people or so to hundreds of thousands, according to them, right? Then you come back and you say, a sister like this is a butch. What is in the mind of religious people when, well, I know what it is. Their religion is being a, they seem that their religion is diminishing.
Shuts down the intellect.
It does not have, they can't go into the museums. If we can get into the Hebrew section, you're going to see the story of the Hebrews from another perspective. Matter of fact, you won't see the Hebrews because you're going to see all the other people and you're going to have to look to find the people that they call Hebrews. But to come here and call this sister a butch in front of black women, why did black women let them leave the building? Forget men. Black women should have got up and said, you monster. Right? But we have to empower our families. So. Didn't even know that she was. No, her name is Iman Echesef, and it is Iman, right? She is of the foremost ladies. So everyone know by her name, Echesef, that she's foremost of the ladies.
Was she a black woman?
Of course she was.
100%.
But see, now, Dala, you gotta understand that now African civilization gave birth to humanity. See, we got to deal, we're going to deal with this conference, and when the Amara Squad come at the conference, we're going to deal with something called black and dark skin. See, just because you're dark skin don't mean you're black.
Right.
Black means a culture, mm-hmm. a love of a people. Dark skin, you got Pakistanis that's dark skin.
Dravidians.
You got a whole bunch of Dravidians. They don't like us.
Right.
You got Native Americans. Dr. Ali Muhammad is going to get up in the conference and start talking about the dark skin Native Americans. They were not black. Black has to do with a culture, right? And a consciousness, and a shared ancestry. So if they got there before we got there, they're not the same.
So I can tell all our people who've been here at the tour, when Dr. Ali Muhammad get up there and he say, you know, life didn't begin in Africa, I want to hear the
that's game over right there.
That's like.
So not only did we build with cement, we built for our families and our fabric, right? So that's why our civilization is lasting, others are not.
right? This is the great mother. For the biblical faves, this is the golden calf. Right? They made the mother, the great mother, something to be wicked, something for Moses to throw the tablets at. But she's just a mother. She's a great mother. She don't have to be extravagant. She just represents all of our mothers. Something that we all come from. Right? Something that we honor, and then again she has achieved. So she's heroic. Right? And she's not only just respected, she's a very key female concept in the female mystery system. And men have to study Hetheru because she's the great mother. And tomorrow maybe I'll talk a little bit more about that.
Do you break down why they use the symbol of the cow to represent this?
Well, of course, obviously we're pastoral people. We come from deeper Africa. The cow has always been sacred, right? Even if we feed from it. Some Africans don't feed from the cow as far as the meat. They just drink the blood and the milk and mix it together, right? To keep the cow alive as possible, right? But the cow delivers children. Children are the wealth. The Africans study cows for their system to figure out how they do it, and then they apply it to us too. So that's why. But she's a great mother because she nurtures her mother, just like the vulture. The vulture takes blood and corpses and brings it back and feeds it to her children from her mouth. Even though it's dying and maybe diseased, but she's saying to her children, this is the best that I can offer you. So eat. Just like we did in the South. Okay, I'm not about a science. See, I'm not as a scientist. The other people see him as bringing a single God. He actually was bringing us science because Kemet was becoming religious. So he was dealing with quantum physics, and so you see the pictures of Ray, and Ray has both the arm and he has the hand as kind of a give and take. His religion of Aten was actually his mother's religion. We know it's his mother's religion because the father, Amenhotep III, right, built a whole lake so that he and his wife could ride around in the Aten boat. Right? So we know that it had much to do with his mother's religion, and all he was just doing was articulating his mother's religion. So when he moved to the capital to tell a monarch to try to create a new Kemet, his mother ruled in Luxor and Thebes for him. Right? So that was a co-regency. Now over here, I'm going to just give myself a break. You can walk around and just see some of the art artifacts, and then I'm going to take you into that room over there, and we're going to continue to talk. So just walk around for a few seconds in this area right here.
This is our mountain right here, everybody.
Most temples in Kemet, right, it starts with the feet. So when you walk into the mysteries, you approach a temple and you usually see two columns which represents the feet, right? And then you go up through the human being. Tomorrow, how many of you heard Swallow the Lubin's Temple of Man? Raise your hand if you've heard Swallow the Lubin's Temple of Man. That all the temples are formulated in Kemet through the man, meaning you go up through the feet, you come up through the system, and you go to the Holies of Holies, which is the inner temple, right? That's the Holies of Holies. Tomorrow I'm going to show you, or I'm going to start to show you today, that it's not the temple of man, it's the temple of woman. It's not the temple of man. So you have the feet, you usually have a mirror pool, and then ultimately the torso of the body, and then you have the mind. Now, this is a fake out because it's in the museum, and that's a real Ptolemy temple, right? And this is a mirror lake representing stages. That is papyrus. That's papyrus right here. That's papyrus. Right? That's the paper.
Okay, but more importantly is, I know what happens, right? We come to an artifact like this, right? Where's Sinjetti? Sinjetti here? What time is it? Close at 9. All right, so look. This, what we do is we approach this and say, who is this? Now, I happen to know, this is Amenhet from that other dynasty that we watched earlier, like the 13th to 15th. But this is not Amenhet. This is someone's favorite Nosut. What Nosut is this? Can anybody help me with the metadata here? Anybody can help me? Well, this is Merin Ptah. This is Merin Ptah. Why is Merin Ptah important? Why do you think the curators put Merin Ptah here? Why? Didn't you go to Kenan on trial? Didn't you hear us debate the Hebrews? Well, Merin Ptah, he conquered some civilizations in Canaan, and there on the Merin Ptah Stela is this, the first writing that people claim that is Israel. But this is Merin Ptah himself. And how do we know? Well, here's Ptah here, and here's Merin Hotep. Merin Hotep. So we know Merin Hotep, and we have, I think, on one of my sheets, I have a good write-up on, if I can find it. Oh, let me just give this out to some of you. Remember that prayer that I was talking about, the Hotep Dinosut? All right, so y'all can pass that around. So that just shows you what this prayer, Hotep Dinosut, looks like. And we're going to see it when we come out one more time. So if you walk up here, I was waiting for some of the Amun-Ra squad to come and help me to be here. All right, so here's Merin Ptah. Right, this is Merin Hotep, Merin Ptah. Now, if we're looking at this, what do you think is the most important artifact in this whole area? Yeah. Yours. This is yours. Yeah. Whatever you're ready. What do you think is the most important artifact in this whole place? Look around. Now, think like a mystery system person.
The water. You said the water.
Yeah.
You said the holy.
So he's talking about the winged serpent, the one that looks like a Mini Cooper symbol. All right. That means man and woman know thyself. That is the whore bear day. That is what that is. But that's not the most important thing in this part of that. Think like a European mason for a second. Just think, because you know we're trained to think like that. We're trained to honor them as if they're the masters of the world. Well, they curated this thing, right? Give me one more shot. What do you think is the most important part of this whole area?
Us.
I like to ask
them. Okay, I got a right answer, so good.
Speaks.
Our history, or what we thought was history, before we went into maybe secondary schools and universities and colleges, was the Bible, right? It was the Bible. And in the Bible is where we got information about, what they say Ham, what they say Abraham, what they say the walk from Ur Chaldea, right, to Haran, to ultimately into Kemet. Did y'all hear that story about Abraham going to Kemet? Did y'all hear that story? Okay, so we're here to see the truth and talk about the truth of history. Not without any necessarily biblical stories. I'm just using that as a backdrop, right? So I'm waiting for the Amun-Ra squad.
There goes some jelly, and I'm going on the other side. I saw over there.
Christian Bale. All right. I'm going to be with us. On the other side of what?
They were going to kill him back in the other side.
Okay. So,
he might go with me.
This is where our story starts. Our story, when we do methodology, it always starts with a map. Our story starts with a map. There's a place, you see where it says York or? That is the place where Abraham supposedly began his voyage. And he went across near the Tigris, Euphrates, and he went to an area called Haran, which is like Lower Phoenicia. And then he crossed over into what they call Canaan, where here they're depicting as Israel. But it was Canaan, it was no Israel.
So this is where it
right? Right? So they added Israel right. In this time period. There ain't no Israel.
Right.
And there's no Judah. Right? And they cross over into Canaan. Sedalia. Yes.
It's a long trip. Just a quote for Brother Reggie saying, can everybody hear me in the back?
Louder.
A little bit louder?
Yeah.
Louder? Okay. The term Hebrew, all right? The term Hebrew is an Englishization, all right, of a Canaanite word or a Phoenician word, okay? So the word Hebrew is an Anglicization or Englishization of a Canaanite term, all right? Because remember, when Abraham crossed, this as Reggie was explaining, when he crossed over and went to the area called Phoenicia or Canaan, the Canaanites looked at the group he was with and called them Eber. Okay? It's not Hebrew. Hebrew is not a Hebrew word. Okay? Make sense? It is a Canaanite word. And it comes from Ha, which is a definite article like the, Eber, which means a crosser over, a nomad, someone who's wandering about. Okay? A Ha Eberu. Okay. The wanderers, the nomads, the people who are just walking around with no home.
Up on top of this theater is the Caucasus Mountains, and across is the Black Sea, right? And over there is Central Asia, right? But the Caucasus Mountains is where you have a phenotype change of what will later become what we call the European, right? But in most of the stuff that we have talked about in early Africa, they really didn't make their appearance until they came across on the side of Greece, or they came down into Anatolia, right? And then the complexions began to change, the phenotypes, because they marched down with their survival culture into the areas of the valleys and the Tigris Euphrates to take control with their warlike new culture. And so you have, in here, you have, what you have is African culture versus this new culture of survival culture coming down. Now, we're here, so then you have the complexion change, you have new phenotypes, right? And you have Phoenicia, which is very important, because early on, all these words, or Canaan, were vassal states of ancient Kemet, when Kemet was at its strong point. And again, Kemet went as far as Greece, right, to with Simbarset, right? And then those little islands over there, Cyprus and stuff, is where they talk about the mystery systems, right? And the stolen legacy. But we're here today, right? To look for the Bible, right? To look to see if any of that stuff matches what a modern day museum has. Now, we're going to see Babylon. We're going to see Anatolia. We're going to see Iran. We're going to see Turkey, right? We see the Caucasus Mountains. We see the story of the Bible or the places, but the people that they're talking about largely live only in the Bible and not in reality. So let's go and look at some of the questions.
What time period? What time are you?
Oh, we're looking at various time periods. In this particular. Right. So we're at the time of what? Prior to
roughly around the time of the period of Moses and stuff like that.
So according to what we're saying, it would be the first 100 years after?
Millennium, that's 1,000 years.
Right. Okay, moving, I'm saying, beyond.
That should be BC. All right. What we're going to find in a lot of this is not traces of the Bible, but we're going to find traces of ancient Kemet. This is what we're going to find in this region because, again, they're civilizing. So let the artifacts say, so over here you will see the Egyptian eye, right? The Wajet, right? And you're going to see, one of the things that you're going to see is with the statues, you're going to see the left foot forward, right? Like Hatshepsut. Right? So you're going to see traces of multiple cultures. Sumer had its own culture, but they're communicating with Nile Valley Africans. So you're going to see that. But you're not going to see what's written in the Bible. That's not what you're going to see. Right? So, now over here, you can obviously see like a set Nebhet, right? You see him? See the wings?
Yeah.
Right.
See now the set Nebhet, right?
The style of the face.
And guess what? You're not going to see any women.
None.
You're not going
to
see.
That's the only piece. That's it's supposed to be a woman depiction.
That's a woman.
If that, right.
So this is not. So what I'm saying, in this civilization, in reality, women just go to dust.
Right.
They're not meaningful. Yeah, that could be a whole thing for.
Middle ages?
No, this is. Some of it is 1,000.
It's first millennium.
First millennium. Right? Because gold is in Kemet. So look, we're in Anatolia, and what do we see in Anatolia? We see aspects.
We see a
that's a falcon. Right? But we see head and rule.
Right.
In Anatolia. Right? So when you're looking for great biblical stuff, you find ancient Kemet.
Wow.
Oh, look. Oh, you see the girl here? Right? Because Sumer was So we just discovered black power in Western Central Asia. So the story that is projected on believers is different than when you actually go to a museum because it doesn't start to make sense. Let's look at the Levant.
This whole game is right.
Now look, these are I took you to a very spiritual place, from a very spiritual place where women is at the center, to a civilization where gods and man, right, or the primary focal point. And women have no value here. Nothing. You choose. You can choose the Bible for its maybe beautiful words, but in reality, this is what the world knows. This is what archaeologists know. Everything here is a study. This is actually a study. These are not things just put up here. People have written PhDs and dissertations that have done lives work on some of these pieces. They're not going to misrepresent history because of a religion. These people are not. But when we get to lecture circuits and we're going to see the great Dr. Ali Muhammad reinvent something again, and we're going to see Zion Lex reinvent something again, I'm not laughing at them to be facetious. This is real study for us. We're human beings. We have a right to tell our children the truth. Instead of saying, well, they took out all the ancient Hebrew stuff because it's going to cause controversy. If it was there, it would be beautiful because it would tell the truth.
Right.
It's just not there.
It's not there.
It's just not there. It's just not there. So you see Baal and El, right? I guess this is a depiction of a sister or a woman. I guess it is, but it's not a very beautiful. But on the side of it,
Murphodon.
If you look, but if you look, but on the side of it, again, you see aspects of Medinet.
What's up?
You see on the back?
on the
Q-form.
That's Q-form.
Snake.
Yeah, but there's
but look how it's styled. Yeah.
It's a common thing.
They got the snake.
Yes, it's cuneiform, but it's put the wrapping.
If you look closely at the carotids, you can see some remnants of Medunetia in it.
That's the snake.
If you look at it real close, look on the end there. Does that not look like the Netra symbol? The Netra symbol, right there.
Yes, they trained it. So it's a pictograph of the shares. Like
I mean, that would be.
Here is where Israel failed.
Big time.
This is the civilization, there are two civilizations that destroyed Israel. Of all of the great journeys that Israel did according to its book, of the great march from Abraham, from Ur-Chaldea to Haran, to Kemet, to misrepresenting his wife as his sister, getting kicked out of Kemet, coming back, for Joseph to be captured as a slave, to be brought into Kemet, becoming a advisor, for the Moses story and the so-called Great Exodus. Israel only lasted for only 400 years. And most of it, if you watch Shaka Amos' presentation and Amara's Squad presentation that they did on Blog Talk, you see that most of that area were vassals. I've already shown you a lot of symbolism of ancient Kemet in the world that they claim is their world. But this civilization, the Assyrian civilization, and you can look at it, this is where the northern kingdom of Israel met its doom. We are not so sure that the Assyrians destroyed Israel. That's what the story said. It has not been scientifically shown that the people that the Assyrians destroyed and the Babylonians were actually, it was actually called Israel or Israel, but they were actually Hebrews. That is just the story. They have not found. What they have found is that there's a lot of information about the conquerors because Kemet came against the Assyrians. For the aid of Hezekiah, right? And he lost his family against the Assyrians. And that also was, and that's later in the 26th dynasty, part of the 26th dynasty, 25th, 26th dynasty.
Indigenous.
Yes, thank you.
And we know the winged disc in Kemet meant know thyself. I know what is in my heart is the translation.
Yes.
So you can even see the Kemetic culture right here. They don't make up these winged discs from nobody. They don't just pop up out the blue.
How did you know that? Culture. Have you been here before, brother?
I've never been here before. I just saw it.
And you just knew it?
I just saw it.
Okay.
Random. So we see this winged disc. We see the influence of the culture. Don't let nobody make you believe that this culture popped up out of nowhere. And it's so close. You saw the map. It's so close to Kemet already.
Where they got it.
And we know, we documented Assyrians did invade Kemet. So they took what they wanted here. And you see the backwards culture here. They have the animal bodies
right.
with the human heads. We have this morphic animal heads on the human body.
Right.
So they're taking our culture and they flip-flop.
We definitely appreciate the tour. We're glad that you came, and we hope that you learned. It can go, so I'm bringing Sineta here because Sineta is in charge of all of this, trying to make this education possible. I work with Sineta. Right? They can say whatever they want to say. All these other channels, I work with Sineta, right? Because Sineta is putting this information out and connecting it in a way that hasn't been connected.
That's right.
I have to ask. It is Bob. Bob.